Hello friends, our next topic is photorespiration. Photorespiration is also called C2 cycle. Rubisco is the enzyme which plays a main key role in the C3 as well as C2 cycle. Rubisco is acting as an oxygenase here in this C2 cycle. At low CO2 concentration, Rubisco acts like oxygenase. In the presence of more CO2 concentration, Rubisco acts as carboxylase. So, Rubisco has two activities, that is oxygenation and carboxylation. Here, it acts as an oxygenase. When higher quantities of O2 concentrations are present, then that condition C2 cycle will observe. When lower concentrations of C2 is present, then C3 cycle will take place. This effect of lower O2 concentration in the atmosphere, that lower concentration results in the C2 cycle. This effect is called Warburg effect. Glycolate by oxygenation reaction with the help of Rubisco enzyme. Here 3-phosphoglycerate is again, which is a 3-carbon compound. This enters into the this is metabolized, and 2-phosphoglycolate is a 2-carbon compound which is not metabolized by C3 cycle. So it enters into the glycolate pathway or C3 cycle or oxidative photosynthetic carbon cycle, which is also called photorespiration. This 2-carbon compound is metabolized by this glycolate pathway. Here the mainly 3 organelles are involved in C2 cycle. That is, the first one is chloroplast, second one is peroxisomes, and third one is mitochondria. Here the first main reaction is here ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate is a 5-carbon compound that is converted into 2-phosphoglycolate, which is a 2-carbon compound, and 3-phosphoglycerate, which is a 3-carbon compound with the oxygen is activity of the Rubisco, and here H2O is enters into this reaction. Here the finally we get 2-phosphoglycolate, which enters into the glycolate pathway. Here the 3 organelles are present. Here this is the chloroplast, this is peroxisomes, and the next one is mitochondria. Here in chloroplast, first initially RUBP is present, which is oxygenated to 2-phosphoglycolate. That 2-phosphoglycolate is again converted into glycolate with the removal of one inorganic phosphate, and next that glycolate enters into the peroxisomes. That glycolate again converted into glyoxylate. Here the H2O2 is produced. Here oxygenation reactions takes place in peroxisomes, so it is named as peroxisomes. Oxygen is converted into H2O2 in peroxisomes when glycolate is converted into glyoxylate. Here this glyoxylate is again converted into glycine, which is a 2-carbon compound, which is an amino acid. That glycine is again entered into the mitochondria, where in mitochondria 2 molecules of glycine is converted into serine, which is a 3-carbon compound. And here 2 molecules of glycine, 2 × 2 = 4 carbons. So out of 4 carbons, 3 carbons will be entered into the formation of serine, and 1 carbon is released out by decarboxylation reaction. Here in mitochondria, oxidative decarboxylation will take place. By this reaction, CO2 is released out, and NH3 also, ammonia is also removed in mitochondria. CO2 and ammonia are produced in mitochondria only. And in next peroxisomes, this serine will enter into the peroxisomes, where it is converted into hydroxypyruvate, that is again converted into glycerate with the help of NADH. This glycerate is again entered into the chloroplast, where it is converted into 3-phosphoglycerate, which is a 3-carbon compound with the utilization of ATP energy. This 3-phosphoglycerate is again entered into the C3 cycle, and RUBP is again regenerated. This is the 3 organelles which involved in C2 cycle. When we compare with C3 plants, C2 plants are lower productive because these C2 plants will release CO2 in this process.